Welcome to the Miami Flow Football Channel, where we break down and talk all Miami football. Today, we're going to be breaking down a quick breakdown of the Miami and the UAB game. My name is Kane Dup, and I will be your host for this breakdown. Before we get going, please go down and click the subscribe button. And if you like this little small video, click the like button as well. Okay, now let's get into the good stuff. As of now, you guys have heard all the opinions, all the negativity, all the positivity. Everybody that's a fan is a coach. They all got something to say, whether it's good or bad. You guys have seen the stats. You've seen the interviews. I just wanted to talk briefly about a couple things that just stuck out to me. The first thing that stuck out to me was the amount of rushing attempts. Yes, I've heard Rhett Lashley talk about if he had to name this type of spread, he would call it more of a power spread offense. But 52 rushing attempts to 27 passing, that just threw me completely off. And yeah, our backs shined. You know, Cam went off, Rooster went off, Don went off. I really was pleased with what I saw. And being that UAB did come out in a completely different defense that we prepared for, I thought that the adjustments on the fly weren't horrible. But let's get to the big topic at hand. How was Derek King going to look on Thursday night? After all the hype, everything we're hearing that he's doing in practice, his leadership, the plays he's making, what would he look like in a Canes uniform? And I'll tell you, I was pretty satisfied. Of course, he was rusty. There were some throws he wished he could have back. But he ran the ball well, and I thought he made some really good throws on the run. And most of all, in my opinion, the most important thing, he never turned the ball over. Now, on the other side of the ball, the defensive side, I thought that's where there were some question marks. Our D-line overall played really well. I thought our D-ends were great. I thought Nesta showed some flashes. He got a little winded, it looked like, late in the second half. Cornerback position, everybody was getting on Ivy's case. But I actually thought the coverage was pretty good, except that the fundamentals broke down. Blades was solid as a rock on the other side. And then our safeties, I thought, were as good as our D-line, to be honest. Where I have my concerns is with Zach McLeod. He looked a little bit slow or rusty. I'm not sure which one. I'm hoping it's rust and he proves me wrong against Louisville, but he definitely looked a step slow for me. Moving forward to the special teams side of the ball, I thought the positive was pretty obvious. We finally have a kicker at the University of Miami that we can have some confidence in. He looked pretty secure. He looked calm. I have full faith in him. The negative, I thought, was Mr. Pope fumbling the ball on the punt and costing us 7 points. There's no doubt that Mr. Pope has a ton of talent. I just hope that it starts showing on the field for the University of Miami. I will say moving forward, I'm going to be nervous when I see him back there. But once he catches the ball, I think I'm going to be very excited because of the talent that he has and what he can do with the ball. Okay, guys, thanks for checking out the video. Once again, this is Miami Flow Football. My name is Kane Dup. Please hit the like button and the subscribe button, and I will see you guys again same time, same place next week. Thank you.